so I bought a new CNC mill. I'm not gonna say how much I paid for it, but I'd say I stole it. Part of the issue was I had to get it out of a garage, and as you can see, this didn't fit, and it didn't fit coming in, but the garage door that I had to get it out of was a lot lower than this even, and I made an offer on it. After briefly looking at it, I threw a ridiculous offer out on it, and they accepted it after a couple days of pondering it. I didn't notice that I couldn't get it out of the garage door, but I think anybody else that came and looked at it would have noticed that initially. And so then I was like, okay, well, I'll just cant the head over like a regular mill. But since it's a CNC version, it only tilts a few degrees. And I didn't have a cherry picker with me the first night I tried to get it out. It was just an ordeal the whole time. I ended up doing a reverse of what you saw with the cherry picker, kind of a not safe setup with the straps going over the top of the boom and the cherry picker, and I was able to get the head down. A friend of mine showed up, helped me out, threw the head in his pickup. I unloaded my skid steer off the trailer, picked it up, put it on the trailer, and hauled it home. So I don't really know what I'm going to do with it exactly, but I think I'm going to do a full retrofit, including replacing the servo motors and everything. So I'm pretty excited about it. It's got ball screws in it. It's a lot further along than if I was to take a regular manual mill and try to convert it to a CNC. It's pretty much, you know, all there. It's you know, limit switches in place and stuff like that, and it's got really nice chrome ways on it. Looks to be in really good shape. The table's obviously a little bit rusty, but I think that'll clean up really well. So stick around for future episodes of a CNC retrofit of a Wells Index 700, and looking forward to it. So a few other talking points about this machine. When I went to go pick the machine up, and I didn't have the cherry picker with me, I thought I could potentially use the head or the table to lower the head down enough to get the machine out the garage. The issue I had with it when I was trying to remove the head was the worm gear that does the canting of the head side to side. Was, you know, it's captured in the gear, and I can't, so I wasn't able to slide the head off, which in reality it kind of probably saved me, because if I was able to get the head off, I probably would have put it on the table and ended up dropping the head, because it wasn't you know, there wasn't a safe way to do it. So the best way to do it was with the cherry picker. So once I finally found the set screw that held the shaft that holds the worm gear, was able to get the head lowered prior to my friend showing up. We rolled the cherry picker out straight to his pickup to put the head in his pickup, and then we used the cherry picker as well to lift up the rest of the machine and haul it to the door, because my skid steer wasn't even able to slide into the garage height-wise.
Yeah, they're all chewed up by mice.
A downfall to the machine, I'm calling it a downfall. It's not really that big of a downfall. The spindle is a rapid switch or quick switch 200, and there's also the Collins rapid switch 200, which is the same spindle taper, but it's not the easiest to find tooling for. I only received this SBI drill chuck, but the perk to it is that I can go, you know, from an R8, as opposed to an R8, as have the fixed tool height set in the machine. So I think it's a better setup than having just an R8 mill that's converted to a CNC machine. In that aspect, it's just unfortunate that the quick switch 200s are kind of hard to find, and they're not the cheapest.
So I ended up using my Linux CNC laptop that I had set up for my CNC router, and just the power and the breakout board and the stepper drivers from my CNC router. The power is way under for what this mill should really be getting. I can't recall right now, 35 volts or something like that output, where it should be around 80 volts. The steppers, I'm running unipolar stepper drivers, and they should be bipolar, I think is the term for it. They're 8-wire steppers. They were wired 6-wire configuration, and I'm using them as a 4-wire configuration. So there's a little bit of downfall there, but I stalled it out a few times, but I think that's mostly to do with the low voltage that I'm running them on. And I also have, with the pre-configured setup for the CNC router, my rapids and speed rates are a lot slower than what they should be for this mill as well.
That's amazing.
I thought I was gonna have to get new motors, replace all these motors.
So like it's ready to work now?
No.
I mean it's like.
I can work it. I can run it.
You think? Don't. I'm encouraged.
Difference in technology.
That's crazy. You should do a video on that.
I will.